This application is one of the most interesting ways of note-taking in the world right now, because it uses something called objects, a very interesting system, and it works offline, local first, encrypted, open source, and markdown. And it's a really interesting application, one that we'll be diving into in this video. If you're interested in it, check it out in the link in the description and find out more. Anytype is a note-taking application. It's got three interesting things about it. It's local first, which means you can use it offline. It's encrypted, which means it's slightly more secure for you taking notes. And also, it uses object-based note-taking, which is a fairly new way of note-taking that many new companies like Capacities, Anytype, and other tools are moving towards as a way to take notes. So let's show you how this works and a little bit more about Anytype to see if it's a note-taking application for you. So you can see here that Anytype is structured very much like many other note-taking applications. On the left side, you can see your widgets, which allows you to quickly access stuff inside of your account. In this case, I've pinned a couple of widgets to this left-hand side. You create widgets from this top right corner. But very simply, let's cut to the chase. Everything starts with an object inside of this account. So here's a daily journal entry as a demonstration. You could, for example, start by saying, I read the book and put 4-hour work week in there by Tim Ferriss today. And obviously these objects are pre-populated in your account, which means you can create them from scratch, but you can actually add more detail to them. So for example, if I click into Tim Ferriss, I can see that I can add a cover photo. For example, here I could add a cover photo to him. I could add some of my notes on him. And this means that every time I'm creating a note relevant to Tim Ferriss, I can see any of the backlinks created. This is perfect for organizing ideas. And most importantly, if I was coming back to this, I could click into the 4-hour work week book and see that it's authored by Tim Ferriss. Now you can create a range of objects, including collections, and you can even go to a library in the bottom left-hand corner and find a range of different types that have been added to my account. For example, video, daily journal, objective, humans, books, bookmarks, and whatever. For example, I saved a link to this page and it automatically saved it as a bookmark, which is really helpful. So objects can be a really helpful way because you can customize the relations within inside them. So for example, if I was particularly interested in having a URL added to the object of human, I could go to types and go over to human and I could change and install this inside of my account and modify it a bit further. Now, this is a really interesting experience because if I go to the graph view, you can start to see relationships between this and how they correlate to other people. So for example, if I wanted to see, okay, Bob Iger is the author of Company of One, I know he's not, and Tim Ferriss is the author of 4-Hour Work Week, I can start to see relationships being built based on the objects versus just your notes. Now, this is a really interesting setup, but it's not the only thing you can do in the account. You can use project management, you can change your layout to grid, Kanban, list, calendar, and even graph view, which allows you to plan some of your projects as a personal management a little bit more effectively. Now, it does have the ability to go in and modify some of the properties like you would see in apps like Notion, but it doesn't have advanced databases that you would typically see in apps like Notion, Coda, and many more. But largely, this application is designed to be a note-taking application. It wants you to plan some of your ideas in here, bring them into one place, and most importantly, use object-based note-taking for that. So it's going to be great for those who want offline access, open source, markdown, and also that encryption level that a lot of people like. They're constantly building to this, and it's very fast to use in some of the tests that I've done already. I'm very impressed with how it's done, and it's an application that I'm keeping an eye on.